In countries across the globe, economic development is disproportionately concentrated in coastal regions. The low-elevation coastal zone below 5 meters, also called the sub-5-meter LECZ, comprises all land area lying at most 5 meters above sea level. While these areas account for just 1% of total land area across the globe, they contain more than 5% of the world's population, encompassing over 300 million people in total. In large part, these patterns reflect that coastal regions historically enjoyed significant advantages for transport and agriculture. And while these advantages may be less relevant today, coastal regions continue to attract a large and growing share of modern infrastructure investment. For example, the density of major roads in the sub-5-meter LECZ is more than double the global average. What implications does climate change have for these investments? Under current projections, the next century will see at least a 5-fold increase in the population that experiences coastal flooding, and a 10-fold increase in flood losses in major coastal cities. Does continued investment in these coastal regions represent a misallocation of resources? Put another way, should policymakers continue to favor coastal regions that are thriving today, but that face substantial environmental risk in the future? This paper studies these questions in the context of Vietnam, a country that is especially vulnerable to climate change. Much of its population is heavily concentrated in areas that face substantial risk under just a 1 meter rise in sea level, a possibility that falls well within the range of projected forecasts over the next century. And yet, the country's development strategy continues to favor the growth of these at-risk regions. This figure shows the evolution of the country's road network from 2000 to 2010. Over this period, infrastructure investments were heavily concentrated in regions that are at high risk of being completely submerged by sea level rise. This paper provides a quantitative assessment of the degree to which this pattern of investment represents a misallocation of resources, and further asks whether overall economic welfare would be improved by instead diverting funds to inland areas. First, the author shows that road upgrades lead to increases in near-term local economic activity. Showing that infrastructure investments are correlated with economic outcomes is not sufficient to establish a causal relationship because the allocation of investments is not randomly determined. In particular, policymakers may choose to focus on regions that are already on an upward economic trajectory. Thus, the author focuses on estimating the effect of upgrades made as part of the Ho Chi Minh National Highway Project, which was started in 2000, and whose route was built to explicitly follow that of the historic Ho Chi Minh Trail, the north-south supply route used by the Viet Cong and the North Vietnamese Army during the Vietnam War. The author argues that because the trail was built for military strategic reasons rather than for economic ones, its route, and therefore the route of the subsequent National Highway Project, is not systematically correlated with factors that would affect economic growth in the 2000s in the absence of the new highway's construction. Results from this analysis show that a 1% increase in proximity to the National Highway is associated with a 2.9% increase in per capita expenditures. This suggests that the strong concentration of road upgrades in coastal regions over the 2000s may, in turn, have increased the concentration of economic activity in these areas. Building on these results, the author then estimates an economic model that allows her to simulate how individuals and firms respond over time to the spatial allocation of infrastructure investments today. By modeling how migration decisions, for example, are affected by road upgrades, the model allows her to expand beyond localized results and to generalize to broader impacts. The model also explicitly incorporates future environmental change, and therefore allows her to quantify the extent to which this affects the trade-off between allocating present-day resources to coastal versus inland development. Simulations from this model show that, relative to the benchmark in which no infrastructure investments are made, overall economic welfare is 1.74% higher as a result of the 2000 to 2010 road upgrades. In the absence of future sea level rise, however, welfare would have been 2.49% higher as a result of the upgrades, indicating the cost of concentrating many of the upgrades in the LECZ. To assess whether the focus on coastal regions constitutes a misallocation of resources, the author compares the welfare gains resulting from the 2000 to 2010 upgrades with those that would have been realized if the same total amount of investment dollars had been employed according to four alternative policies. The first two neither explicitly favor nor avoid coastal regions, while the latter two require that all updates are made outside of the 5-meter and 1-meter LECZs, respectively. Under the assumption that there is a gradual 1-meter sea level rise over the next century, alternatives 2 through 4 all substantially outperform the upgrades that policymakers actually chose to pursue over the 2000s. Interestingly, this is also true when the model is simulated under the assumption of no sea level rise. This suggests that, even absent future climate change, policymakers are over-investing in coastal areas, perhaps due to policy path dependence. Placing the counterfactual analyses side by side reveals that taking future sea level rise into account renders the investments that were actually chosen over the 2000s substantially less advantageous relative to the hypothetical alternatives. For example, while avoiding the 1-meter LECZ leads to a 48% welfare gain in the scenario with no sea level rise, this number jumps to 72% under the assumption of a 1-meter rise. In conclusion, this paper argues that climate change substantially affects the optimal allocation of infrastructure investment. Even absent environmental risk, allocating investment away from coastal regions leads to large returns. Adding the additional factor of environmental change highlights the misallocation even more starkly. To explore more on this topic, you can take a look at the full paper, as well as its references to other related research. These include papers studying the link between infrastructure investments and the spatial pattern of economic development, and empirical literature studying the local economic effects of upgrading road networks, and finally, research on path dependence and myopia in policymaking.